इट इज द लिंक ऑफ कैलस कल्चर. सस्पेंशन कल्चर इज द कल्चरिंग ऑफ आइसोलेटेड सेल इन अ लिक्विड मीडियम. सस्पेंशन कल्चर इज अ टाइप ऑफ कल्चर इन विच सिंगल सेल्स और द स्मॉल एग्रीगेट्स ऑफ अ सेल्स मल्टीप्लाई वाइल सप्लीमेंटेड इन अ एजिटेटेड लिक्विड मीडियम. सेल्स कैन बी आइसोलेटेड फ्रॉम इन विट्रो प्लांट मटेरियल आइदर बाय मैकेनिकल मीन्स और थ्रू द एंजाइमेटिक डाइजेशंस एंड फ्रॉम द कैलस इंड्यूस्ड फ्रॉम एनी एक्सप्लांट्स. टू अचीव एन आइडियल सेल सस्पेंशन मोस्ट कॉमनली अ फायबल कैलस इज ट्रांसफर टू एजिटेटेड लिक्विड मीडियम वेयर इट ब्रेक्स अप एंड रेडिली डिसअपीयर. सेल सस्पेंशन कल्चर इज इनिशिएटेड फ्रॉम वर्चुअली एनी पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट जस्ट एज अ कैलस कल्चर. सस्पेंशन कल्चर इज अ ट्रांसफरिंग एन इनोकुलम ऑफ अ फ्रायबल कैलस टू अ लिक्विड मीडियम एंड देन प्लेसिंग इन ऑन अ मैकेनिकल ऑर्बिटल प्लेटफॉर्म शेकर एट अ 100 to 150 RPM. द कैलस इंडक्शन मीडियम कंसिस्ट ऑफ अगार एंड अ मिक्सचर ऑफ मैक्रो एंड माइक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट फॉर द गिवन सेल टाइप्स. The liquid medium is typically similar in composition to the one on which the callus was grown. These suspensions can then be propagated by regular subculture of an aliquot of the fresh medium. Ideally, suspension culture should consist of only single cells which are physiologically and biochemically uniform. The movement of the cell in relation to nutrient medium facilitates gaseous exchanges, removes any polarity of the cell due to gravity, and eliminates the nutrient gradient within the medium and at the surface of the cells. Cell suspension culture requires the Murashig and Scoob medium, white medium and woody plant medium. Woody plant medium is required for the hardwood plants, and Murashig and Scoob means the MS media is required any plant type of the plants or material. Then what is the protocol for the cell suspension culture? How get the cell suspension culture from a explant? Take a 150 to 250 ml conical flask containing autoclave 40 to 60 ml liquid medium, means it contains the artificial nutrient media. Then transfer a 3 to 4 piece of pre-established callus tissues from the culture tube using the spoon headed spatula to conical flask. Then flame of the neck, means this neck is flame with the spirit lamp, and close the mouth of the flask with the piece of aluminium foil or the cotton plug. Then cover the closer with the piece of brown paper. Then this conical flask is covered with the brown paper. Then place the flask within the clumps of the rotary shaker. This is the rotary shaker, and place the your flask on a rotary shaker. Then and this rotary shaker is moving at the 80 to 120 RPM. RPM means revolution per minute. Then after 7 days, pour the contents of each flask through the sterile sieves and collect the filters in a big sterilized containers, and then this is the filtration process, and this then add into the sterile containers, and only free cells or the cell aggregates you get. Then all the filtrates of the cells are settled down for the 10 to 15 minutes or centrifuged, means then centrifuged the filtrate at 500 to 1000 rpm, and finally pour off the suspendant. Then resuspend the residual cells in a requisite volume, and thus these cells add into the fresh liquid medium and dispense the cell suspension equally in the several sterile flasks. Place the flask on a shaker and allow the free cells and aggregate to grow. All the next subcultures repeat the previous steps, but take only 1/5 of the residual cells as the inoculum. Inoculum is used for the culturing the more and more callus, and dispense equally in a flask and again place them on a shaker. After 3-4 subcultures, transfer the 10 ml of cell suspension from the each flask into the new flask containing 30 ml of fresh liquid media, and this culture is used for getting the secondary metabolites. Then callus is extract and get the secondary metabolites compounds. Then this callus culture is used to extract the secondary metabolites compounds. Then this callus is plotting into the cell suspension culture and get the single cell of the aggregates, and this cell is divided, and then you get the embryoids, and from the embryoids you form the whole regenerated plants. Means from a single cell you get the whole plant, and this process is called as regeneration of the plants. Next is the different categories of suspension culture. Suspension culture is divided into the two categories. One is the batch culture and second one is the continuous culture. Then batch culture is again categorized or the distinguished is the slowly rotary culture. Then second one is the shakery culture, shake culture. Third one is the spinning culture and fourth one is the stirred culture. Then continue culture is again divided or the categories on two halves. Then one is the chemostat and second one is the turbidostat. What is the batch culture? Batch culture is a type of suspension culture where the cell material grow in a finite volume of aggregated liquid medium. The batch culture or the batch suspension culture are most commonly maintained in a conical flask at the speed of 80 to 120 rpm. And this culture is again classified into the different categories. Then this is the diagram or the procedure of the बैच कल्चर, दिस इज द रोटरी शेकर एंड दिस इज द कोनिकल फ्लास्क. योर रोटरी शेकर इज कंटिन्यूसली शेक योर कल्चर. योर कल्चर इज कंटेनिंग द लिक्विड मीडियम एंड योर कल्चर इज यूनिफॉर्मली ग्रो. एंड दिस कल्चर, दिस रोटरी शेकर स्पीड इज 80 to 120 RPM. देन अगेन इट इज अ कैटेगरी. फर्स्ट वन इज द स्लोली रोटेटिंग कल्चर. सिंगल सेल एंड अ सेल एग्रीगेट्स आर ग्रोन इन अ स्पेशल डिजाइन फ्लास्क. दिस इज द स्पेशल डिजाइन फ्लास्क. द निपल फ्लास्क, ईच निपल फ्लास्क पजेस द 8 निपल लाइक अ प्रोजेक्शन. दिस इज द 8 निपल लाइक प्रोजेक्शंस. द कैपेसिटी ऑफ ईच फ्लास्क इज द 250 ml. 10 फ्लास्क आर लोडेड इन अ सर्क्यूलर मैनर ऑन अ लार्ज फ्लास्क डिस्क ऑफ द वर्टिकल शेकर. व्हेन द फ्लैट डिस्क रोटेट्स एट द स्पीड ऑफ 1 to 2 RPM, द सेल 1 to 2 RPM. देन द सेल्स विद इन द ईच नीपल ऑफ द फ्लास्क आर अल्टरनेट बार इन अ कल्चर मीडियम एंड एक्सपोज टू एयर. देन सेकेंड वन इज द शेक कल्चर. इट इज अ वेरी सिंपल एंड इफेक्टिव सिस्टम ऑफ द सस्पेंशन कल्चर. इन दिस मेथड सिंगल सेल्स एंड सेल एग्रीगेट्स इन अ फिक्स्ड वॉल्यूम ऑफ अ लिक्विड मीडियम आर प्लेस्ड इन अ कोनिकल फ्लास्क. कोनिकल फ्लास्क आर माउंटेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ द क्लिप्स एंड दिस इज द क्लिप्स एंड इन विच यू पुट यूर कल्चर्स और द कोनिकल फ्लास्क ऑन अ हॉरिजॉन्टल लार्ज स्क्वेयर प्लेट्स ऑफ एन ऑर्बिटल. दिस इज द ऑर्बिटल प्लेटफॉर्म प्लेटफॉर्म शेकर. द स्क्वेयर प्लेट्स मूव्स बाय द सर्क्यूलर मोशन एट द स्पीड ऑफ 82. योर प्लेट इज मूविंग एट सर्क्यूलर मोशंस एंड दिस स्पीड इज द 60 to 180 RPM. देन थर्ड वन इज द स्पिनिंग कल्चर. लार्ज वॉल्यूम ऑफ सेल सस्पेंशंस मे बी कल्चर्ड इन अ 10 लीटर बॉटल्स. मीन्स इट इज द लार्जेस्ट बॉटल और द लार्जेस्ट कल्चर दैन द रिमेनिंग और बिफोर टू कल्चर्स. इन विच वी आर रोटेटेड इन अ कल्चर स्पिनर. मीन्स दिस इज अ रोटेटेड स्पिनिंगली एट द 120 RPM एट एन एंगल 45°C. देन फोर्थ वन इज द स्टड कल्चर. स्टीरिंग मीन्स द स्टीर कल्चर. दिस सिस्टम इज ऑल्सो यूज फॉर द लार्ज स्केल बैच कल्चर. दिस सिस्टम यूज फॉर लार्ज स्केल कल्चर्स. मीन्स 1.5 टू 10 लीटर ऑफ कल्चर ग्रोइंग दिस सिस्टम. इन दिस मेथड द लार्ज कल्चर वेसल इज नॉट रोटेटेड बट द सेल सस्पेंशन इनसाइड द वेसल इज केप्ट डिस्पर्स कंटिन्यूसली बाय द बबलिंग स्टराइल एयर थ्रू द कल्चर मीडियम. द यूज ऑफ एन इंटरनल मैग्नेटिक स्टरर. यूज ऑफ इंटरनल मैग्नेटिक स्टरर इज द मोस्ट कन्वीनियंट वे ऑफ एजिटेटिंग और द एजिटेट द कल्चर मीडियम सेफली. द मैग्नेटिक स्टरर रिवॉल्व्स एट 200 to 600 RPM. द कल्चर वेसल्स इज द 5 to 10 liters राउंड बॉटम फ्लास्क. मीन्स यू रिक्वायर द राउंड बॉटम फ्लास्क फॉर दिस ग्रोइंग कल्चर्स. देन What is the continuous culture? It is the second category of cell suspension culture. First one is the batch culture, then second one is the continuous culture. This system is a very much similar to stir culture, but in this system the old liquid medium is continuously repeated by the fresh liquid medium to stabilize the physiological state of the growing cells. The large culture vessel is a cap dispersed continuously by the bubbling sterile air through the culture medium, and the old liquid medium is continuously replaced by the fresh liquid medium to stabilize the physical state of the growth cells. Normally, the liquid medium is not changed until the depletion of some nutrients in the medium and the cells are kept in the same medium for the certain period. As a result, active growth phase of the cell declines the depletion of the nutrients. Then, in a continuous culture system, nutrient depletion does not occur due to the continuous flow of nutrient medium, and the cells always remain in the steady state of active growth phase. Then, continuous culture is again category in two steps. One is the chemostat and second one is the thermostat. Chemostat means it is a bioreactor to which a fresh medium is continuously added, while a culture liquid containing leftover the nutrients, metabolic end products and the microorganisms are continuously removed at the same rate to keep the culture volume constant. It is a media reservoir bottle and it is the chemostat vessels in which the air bubbles is created, and it is the collecting replaceables. In this system, culture vessels are generally cylindrical. The culture vessel is a cylindrical or circular in a shape and possess inlet and outlet pores, and it is a possess inlet and outlet pores for the aeration and the introduction of and removal of the cell and the mediums. The liquid medium containing the cells is a stir. Liquid medium is continuously stirred by the magnetic stirrer. This is the magnetic stirrer, and continuously your culture is stirring. The introduction of fresh sterile medium, which is the pump in at a constant rate into a vessels, is balanced by the displacement of an liquid medium or the liquid or equal volume of the spent or old medium and cells. Such a system can be maintained in a steady state. This system is steady in a state so that new cells are produced by division at a rate which compensate the number lost in the outflow of the spent medium. Thus, in a steady state condition, the density growth rate or the chemical compositions and metabolic activities of the cells all remains constant. Such a continuous cultures are ideal for studying growth kinetics and regulation of metabolic activity in a higher plant. Then second part or the second category is turbidostat. The turbidity of the suspension culture medium is changes rapidly when the cell increase in the number due to their steady state. The changes of the turbidity of the culture medium can be measured by the changes of the optical density of medium. Turbidostat is a continuous microbiologically culture device similar to a chemostat or an oxostat. A chemostat has a fixed volume and follow the rate and thus a fixed dilution rate. The turbidostat dynamically adjusts the flow rate and therefore the dilute rate are changed or to make the turbidity constant. This diagram is the turbidostat. Then what is the phase of growth curve? Means your callus is a grow and how long it's stay or after that it is a die. And this is the growth curve of the life cycle of the callus. And what the different phases of the callus? Different phases of growth of the callus. Cell in suspension can exhibit much higher rate of the cell division than those in a callus culture. The suspension culture, when maintained under the control condition of light, temperature and aeration flow, a predictable growth curve is the culture first passes through a lag phase. The culture passes through the lag phase and in which there is the little growth, means small callus is grown. The lag phase is a period when the cell adjusts to replenish the supplies of nutrients and undertake all the necessary synthesis prior to the cell division. The cultures then pass through a logarithmic phase or the logarithmic phase or the exponential phase of the growth, in which cell is divided very rapidly. Means at that phase your cells are differentiated, multiply or rapidly, causing a logarithmic increase in the cell numbers. Under the optimum condition, cell numbers double every 20 to 50 hours, means your cells is multiplied in 20 to 50 hours depending on the species. Then the cultures pass through the further period of rapid cells division. Then result is a linear increase in number, or this is process or phase is called as a stationary phase. And at that time the cell growth is slow at the end of the phase as one or more nutrients become limiting. The cultures then reach the stationary phase when the rate of the cell division within the culture decreases, means your growth of the culture is decreases and cell number is stabilized, or your cell number is stabilized, means the constant, and growth finally built or the health. As the nutrients are depleted, some of the cells of the culture begins to slow sensations are the this phase is called as decline phase, and a low level of cell division will maintain the cell numbers and cells are left in a stationary phase. Now this phase is steady, and phase 2 long and they will be die, and this phase is called as a decline phase, and these all are the growth phases of callus cultures or the cell suspension cultures. These are the days required for growth of callus, and these one are the cells number. In a lag phase, your cells are undergrowing. In a exponential phase, your cells is highly multiplied. In a stationary phase, at that phase, your cell multiplication or the multiplication of the cells is steady, and that phase is the decline phase, your cells will be die. Then advantages of the suspension culture is, one is the provides the better control for the scale up of the cell suspension culture. Second one is the constant regulations of over the various stages of the operations. Then your cell suspension culture reduce the cost of cultivations or cost of productions. Then your cell suspension culture is easily handling of the cultures, such as the inoculation of the cultures or the harvest. It is also easier. It is a shorter duration and continuous process. Then it enhances the uptake of the nutrients in a summer cells. Means you grow your callus in a liquid medium, and this is the situation is called as a summer situations or the submerged culture. It is a easier production and a scaling up of a large number of plantlets. It is a higher yield of bioactive compounds, and these are the advantages of cell suspension culture. Some importance of cell suspension culture is, to obtain a single cell clones, means from the callus you get the single cell and you clone, multiply so many clones. To study the morphological and biochemical changes during their growth and development phases, to understand the pathway of cellular metabolism. Then single cell system have a great potential for crop improvement. Free cells in cultures permits a quick administration and withdrawal of the diverse chemical or the substances, thereby making them easy targets for a mutant selection. Means for the mutant selection, you go through the cell suspension culture. Cells which are in a population of culture cells invariably show a cytogenetically and metabolic variations depending on the stages of the growth cycle and culture heterogeneously. To induce a high yielding cultures as well as plants with a superior agronomic traits, single cells derived from a medically important plants can be studied for the production of secondary metabolites like alkaloids or the glycosides. For the mutagenesis studies, the mutagens can be added directly in a liquid medium. Mutagens are directly add into the liquid medium. After the mutagen treatment, cells are planted in an agar medium for the selection of mutant cell clones. The hope in that permanent changes in a DNA pattern of the some of the cells would be achieved by a such a treatments. These are the importance of cell suspension culture. Thank you everyone.